Thank you. Good. I did not even notice it, but all right.
Thank you. lost in the greenness of dawn, stood around the child, shifting the frame that surrounded the child in the palpable darkness of the temple. The temple enclosed them in forests of stone. Its lofty vaults stooped as though trying to cloak the prophetess Anna and Simeon and Mary, to hide them from men and to hide them from heaven. And only a chance ray of light struck the hair of the sleeping infant, who stirred, but as of yet was conscious of nothing and blew drowsy bubbles. Old Simeon's arm held him like a stout cradle. It had been revealed to this upright old man that he would not die until his eyes had seen the Son of the Lord. And it thus came to pass. And he said, "Now, O Lord, lettest thou thy poor servant, according to thy holy word, leave in peace. For mine eyes have witnessed thine offspring. He is thy continuation, and also the source of thy light. Idolatrous tribes, and the glory of Israel as well." Then old Simeon paused, the silence, regaining the temple's clear space, oozed from all its corners and almost engulfed them. And only his echoing words graced the rafters to spin for a moment with faint rustling sound. High over their heads in the tall temple's vaults, akin to a bird that can soar, yet that cannot return to earth, even if it should want to. A strangeness engulfed them. The silence now seemed as strange as the words of old Simeon's speech. And Mary, confused and bewildered, said nothing. So strange had his words been. He added, while turning directly to Mary, "Behold, in this child, now close to thy breast, is concealed the great fall of many, the great elevation of others, a subject of strife and a source of dissension. And that very steel which will torture his flesh shall pierce through thine own soul. And that wound will show to thee, Mary, as in a new vision, what lies hidden deep inside the hearts of all people." He ended and moved toward the temple's great door. Old Anna, bent down with the weight of her years, and Mary, now stooping, gazed after him, silent. He moved and grew smaller, in size and in meaning, to these two frail women who stood in the gloom. As though driven on by the force of their looks, he strode through the cold, empty space of the temple and moved toward the lightning blur of the door. The stride of his old legs was steady and firm. When Anna's voice sounded behind him, he slowed his step for a moment. She was not calling him. She had started to bless God and praise him. The door came still closer. The wind stirred and his robe and fan on his forehead. The roar of the street exploding in life by the door of the temple. He strode through the space that was no longer. He went forth to die. It was not the loud din of the streets that he faced when he flung the door wide, but rather the deaf and dumb fields of death's kingdom. He strode through a space that was no longer solid. The rustle of time ebbed away in his ears, and Simeon's soul held the form of the child.
Thank you.